Right, welcome to the webinar. We will wait for 1 minute still to everybody to come in, and then we will start. Okay, now it's 10 o'clock Finnish time and we will start the webinar. We have a very interesting topic today, the Power Up Your Project Portfolio Management with ChatGPT and AI. And this is a joint webinar between Innofactor and Projectum, which is our partner in project and portfolio management systems. And here's the agenda. We will have a short intro, and then we will go to presentation and demos. And then we have 10 minutes reserved in the end for questions and answers. And if you have any questions during the presentation, please just put them in the questions part, and we will then answer them in the end. So welcome everyone. My name is Jaakko Heikkinen. I'm a lead consultant in Innofactor, working in advisory and consulting services. And this is extremely interesting topic for me as well. And I'm really, really, really interested to hear that what Jacob Hansen from Projectum will tell us about their offering in this, or our joint offering in this this part. Jacob, do you want to say a few words?
Yeah, thank you for inviting me, and hello to everyone calling out from Denmark, close to the German border. So nice to be here today, and I will primarily do the demos and the presentation on this topic today.
Excellent. So let's move on to the first slide. This is kind of my own messy slide. I didn't show this to the marketing beforehand, but this is kind of how I think I wanted to present this idea. So AI is now in everybody's lips and everybody's talking about this, but it is old news as we all know it. So the AI was born in the 50s, and here's the picture of an IBM machine from the 50s, and that was the type of machines that the first AI solutions were made. And it was even in adequate level with the checkers and chess in the 50s. So it was born quite early. And then there was the first kind of hype phase between 1956 and 1974. And there was even the first chatbot at that time, and first autopilot landing in 1964. So even the planes were using type of artificial intelligence at that time. Of course, there was lots of mechanics involved as well. And Marvin Minsky, who was a very famous computer scientist at the moment, predicted that there will be a general intelligence of an average human being in 3 to 8 years. That would mean like mid-70s. And of course, we all know that that didn't happen. And once it didn't happen, there was the first AI winter between 74 and 1980. And it was mainly due to lack of computing power, and the great ideas that people have just didn't come through. And it meant that the funding ended at that time. But then there was the kind of second boom of AI between 1980 and 87. Which was mainly due to rise of the expert systems. So the general intelligence idea was abandoned, really. But there were ideas to use this in certain industries, in certain like, well, in expert system type of things and the money returned. And for example, US military, DARPA, was investing heavily on the AI. But then again, the hype was bust. And there was the second AI winter between 1987 and 1993, and it was mostly due to the rise and availability of the desktop computers, which made the specialized AI hardware really not usable, too expensive, and they vanished. And over 300 AI companies were shut down and went bankrupt at that time. But then from 1993, it's been a gradual kind of improvement in the AI. Of course, we know that the Deep Blue versus Kasparov, 1997, it broke then. It was a big news when it won the world champion in chess. It was 10 million times faster than it, the same chess computer in 1951. There was the DARPA challenge with the robot driving along in desert autonomously. And yeah, it's fun. I remember all these when I was at that age because it was very interesting. And then there was deep learning, big data, AGI from 2011 to this date, IBM Watson winning Jeopardy in 2011. And but of course, at that time, these were just interesting things, nothing that would really connect to me as an individual, as an end user. The systems were mainly used by large corporations or scientists, and there was really nothing for an average size company or small size company or individual end users to get hold of the AI. So they were just news at that time. And there were business like IBM Watson Health, $1 billion business in 2022, but still facing problems with profitability, and it was actually sold partly to another company. But then what happened in 2023, it was the explosion of public interest, and that really changed everything. And so the ChatGPT, 1 million users in 5 days, 100 million in 2 months, and that means the public interest within the public, within every company, means that there are huge investments ongoing right now. Like Microsoft, 10 billion to OpenAI, Google, 400 million, not so much, but I bet they are investing even more. Meta is predicted to spend $33 billion to AI this year. And Amazon, Alibaba, Elon Musk's X, that AI, and there's lots of things happening. And now, of course, some people think that is this a hype? Is this going to go bust? I think not, because of the public interest, because of the tens and tens of usable solutions, or hundreds or thousands usable solutions for every company and for every people. And it's just it's an amazing time to be alive. And Jacob Hansen will now show one type of solution that is here now. So AI is here now. It's not the news anymore. It's not the headline, but it's here in everyday use. And Jacob, just take it away and show us what you got.
Yeah, thank you. So my biggest concern about AI is that are people ready to adopt it, because it's already there. And I think today we're going to see that it's already there. And what does it mean that it's already there? You know it from all the social media kind of stuff. It is out there already. But what about product portfolio management? How can I take AI and combine it with my daily job as a project manager, my daily job as a PMO, portfolio manager? That might be a bigger concern, how we take AI into companies. If you just remember 20 years back, companies afraid of internet, about cloud computing, about storing cloud data, that's the same journey we're going to go through now. And now the companies are afraid of AI. And why? Because how can we use it? Is it secure? Can I trust it? Does it take over control of my company? All those kind of questions, they're good questions. But I don't think that we should be so afraid, because just imagine a world without internet today. Imagine a world without a computer or cloud storage, right? you will not find your iPhone again, never. So it's all about trust technology and of course be curious. And let's take the jump into to the scene of a PPM world. I'm a project portfolio manager. I am a project manager. I'm a resource manager. I am a resource participant. I work in a company where project is 80% of the entire work of the company. And how can I, as an employee in different roles, actually play around with AI? How can I play around with the Power PPM system? Power PPM is a project portfolio management system that creates a portfolio of projects, connects strategies into it. And how can I utilize Microsoft technology? Because I come from a Microsoft partner, InnoFactor is a Microsoft partner. And as we saw in the investment, Microsoft is putting so many money into the investments of AI, but not only AI, also still the three clouds of Microsoft, where you store your data in the cloud and you have your business applications in the cloud. So how can we bring AI, open AI, ChatGPT technology together with a PPM system and together with Microsoft technology stack? How can we merge that together and then for the benefit of that, make a daily job as a project manager, portfolio manager easier? And that's what I'm going to prove today, is that it's already there. It's up to you to take the advantage of it. And if you wait 5 months, if we do the same webinar in 5 months, I will show you totally different things that are advanced over time. Just last night, I got from our developer a new feature I can show today. I didn't have it 2 days ago. It's with a pace that we have never seen before. So first, I will talk about project portfolio management and how I see project portfolio management, because it's so many different disciplines. And then I'm going to take the AI perspective on that. When I'm done with my slide, I'm going to jump into the live system. I'm going to demo a flow where I utilize the AI capabilities in the context of a project portfolio management system. So let's take it away. I have a company. My company, we have work to do. We meet into work every day and we do it for one reason. Our company wants to earn money. That kind of work has two different flavors today. If I am a construction company, very traditional. I'm going to build a road, I will plan it, I will build the road, and I will maintain the road afterwards. But if I'm a software company, I might work very agile. I have an agile portfolio. We will work in sprints, we will work in increments, we will work agile methodologies. All that kind of work might be agile, might be traditional. It can be grouped into different portfolios. So, InnoFactor. They earn their money by having customers like you. That means that they invoice you. They have a billable portfolio. They have a portfolio of customers with a lot of work to be done. Then they earn the money. But they definitely also have an internal portfolio because they do optimization and they do marketing and they do sales stuff. So that is internal stuff that is not related and paid by customers. In Projectum, we have a product portfolio because we create apps to the Microsoft platform. Microsoft has a product portfolio because they have products that they sell to you. And all companies, they might have a strategy portfolio because there is some senior management on top. Maybe they do it in PowerPoint, maybe they do it on a whiteboard, maybe they do it at a C-level meetings, but they agree on a strategy. And that strategy then tell grow in the billable portfolio, customer portfolio, or create more products. And that strategy is on very top of the company's work. So how can we bring strategy on top level all the way down to the execution of traditional and agile? Because at C level, they don't understand Kanban boards and they don't understand story points and they don't understand progress on a task. They understand money, strategy value, and the direction of the company. And then they might think of a strategy. Then we could challenge them in the context of AI, because maybe AI could create their strategy in the future. I'm going to show that today. I can actually create a strategy based on ChatGPT, and then I can implement my strategy and create projects also with use of AI. So basically, we don't need management anymore, or do we? Because what comes first, the AI that gives the input to the management team, or actually a system that builds up the strategy on its own, because it could be more clever than the management team. That might be a challenge for the management team out there. So if we're going to do that work on the left side, then we're going to bring in management disciplines. If we want to have strategy in our company, we need to have strategy management. We need some people to take care of strategy management. Maybe AI could help in doing that. If I'm going to do portfolio management, I need portfolio management discipline. If I'm going to do risk management, I need risk management discipline. So to do work that we have on the left side, we need management disciplines and people with certification and knowledge to do that kind of work. And there are lots of methodologies around this. I can be certified PMI project manager, and then I can be very good at being a project manager, do project management discipline. But when I do project management disciplines, I need some capabilities. As a project manager, I need a plan where I can create a project schedule. If I'm a strategy manager working in the PMO or strategic office of a company and do strategic management, strategy deployment, that kind of business processes, I might need a roadmap of strategy. So what we can offer with the offering that we're going to see later is actually all of these capabilities. They are in the box, and the management disciplines that you see here, they are in the box. And then we can enable AI, because AI is just a capability. And then imagine that we take this AI capabilities and bring that into strategy management. How can we use AI as a capability to support strategy management? How can I put it in as risk management? How can I put it as project management? So today I'm going to do a live demo of three of those management disciplines. The strategy management, I'm going to build a strategy with help of AI. I'm going to work as a project manager and do a project management and scheduling. So I'm going to build a project schedule with help of AI. And I'm going to do risk management and ask ChatGPT about risk management and let it help me calculate probability and impact, because that is important when you do risk management. So those three scenarios is what I'm going to deep dive into. But all of those capabilities are in the box of the software solution that you will see today. And the software solution is called Power PPM. It's a model-driven power app that runs on the Microsoft technology stack. And then on top of everything, you have a process in your company. If you work with strategy, you might work with OKR, objective and key results. If you work as a project manager, you might be PMI, Project Management Institute focused, or Prince 2. There might be different methodologies, ITIL, SAFe, if you're working with agile frameworks. So those process frameworks, they can be applied on top of the system. We could even ask AI to help. Please create a project schedule based on a Project Management Institute PM book template. Then it creates a project schedule template based on a process framework. So even process frameworks can be applied on top of the capabilities. And that needs a project manager to go to a training before understanding how many stage gates there are in a PMI model. But ChatGPT AI can actually help it within 1 minute. So maybe project managers does not need to be certified anymore in the future. Or do they need to be certified in AI to let AI help them building a project schedule and then maybe be good to work with people? Because I guess in the future, AI will not be that good to work with people as you and me. But maybe the competencies of a project manager will change in the future. So now I'm going to highlight a company on top. And today I'm going to show how I put strategy into the system. I ask ChatGPT of help for a strategy. When I put in a strategy, that could be I want to grow the Finnish market with 30% with a new customer base. That strategy can be put into the system. Then it can create projects that might be internal projects. Before we also talked about billable projects. It's another kind of project. But today I'm going to talk about internal projects. I'm going to build internal projects. I'm going to build a project schedule. And that means that when I do an execution of the project, I might go traditional in my execution or I might go hybrid. I could also go agile. But I'm going to build a project schedule based on ChatGPT that helped me, based on my strategy that has created a project, that created a project schedule that could be for a marketing project. And then I'm going to execute that project. And in that project, I'm also going to look at the at the risk management. So as a project manager in the internal project portfolio, I'm going to look at the risk management piece. And at the end, I'm going to show you from Microsoft, there is a new technology around called Copilot. And Copilot is Microsoft's answer where they enable AI into a chat kind of technology. So I could actually ask my portfolio how many projects are it, and then the chat will come back with the answers running real time on the cloud data. I could also ask for a recommendation. Should I stop this project if I am not going to spend any more money? So this way, Copilot can work together with the entire data set that we have. So artificial intelligence are all below as a platform. Microsoft has created this technology. So we didn't invent it. Infactor didn't invent it. Microsoft did. We just enabled that into a product performance management world. So the apps we're going to see today, that will be the Microsoft Power PPM app created by Projectum. This is the project portfolio management system. So here we're going to create strategy, we're going to create schedules, we're going to create a risk register. And by doing this, we will enable ChatGPT and the capabilities from the platform. All data are stored on Dataverse, so we are in the Microsoft Cloud. And we are in Dataverse and in the Power Platform. So this is how the technology platform, if some of you are technical interested. The Dynamics platform can be enabled with the PPM system, but you could also install directly on the Microsoft Power Platform, the PPM system. The PPM system is called Power PPM and can exist both in the Dynamics and in the Power Platform. ChatGPT is all around here, and then simply we enable that technology into the Power Platform dataset. We also have some other apps that could be used in PPM. Team Planner is for resource management. Time for Teams is for timesheeting. Power Hub is for advanced historical reporting. And if there are some time left today, I could actually, in what if simulation, I could simulate my company strategy and place my project in time and see the impact on money and on resources. So if there will be some time at the end, I will quickly show how I could actually, when I have created my strategy with AI, I could then afterwards do a simulation on it. So let's take away with the AI focus. This is what we think about AI, or what Microsoft thinks of AI. AI has been around for a long time. It is still around, and it will be around for the coming many, many years. Microsoft see it the way that, look at it at the same way as they created a computer 40 years back, right? It is a new era. It is technology at the same level as personal computers impacted us so many years, or the mobile phone impacted us when Nokia created the boom around having a mobile device. Just imagine the world without it. When we're going to look back in 10 years, we will look at AI the same way that it changed the entire industry. So this is not just a new technology coming up. This is industrial revolution. There have been few industrial revolutions during the last 200 years. This is one of them. You also saw quick numbers on the first slide presented by Innofactor. This is basically the same slide, just compare the data. How much time does it take to get 1 million users? I think you mentioned 5 days, right? You can barely see it on this graph because it's just a thin line, right? Look at Netflix, how many days they actually use to get those numbers. It is escalating rapidly, 1.8 billion in April. On monthly basis. So it is insane how fast AI, ChatGPT technology comes into the hands of all people. Yesterday, I used ChatGPT to create this presentation, right? Why not? My girlfriend's working company, they need a new logo yesterday. She came home and then she said, yeah, we asked Chat and the AI technology for a new logo and they came up with 10 logos and we choose one of them. but could we do it? Do we own the rights to it? Then the questions start coming, right? But the technology is there and it goes insane fast. So today AI is everywhere. And you can read a lot of stuff about it. McKinsey, they have books around it already now. So it's really important that your management team, they start having a strategy for AI. Because if they are not around with AI in 2 months, 3 months, or 1 year, slowly that will be a competitive advantage for your competitors, if they are. So what does it take for a company like you to take AI and enable that in your company? McKinsey has this study where they look at the cost of it, implementing AI, the technology talent, so the competences of your tech people. How good should a tech people in a company understand AI to enable AI for that company? And what about the data? And the funny thing here is that if you look at the study and open up the tech talent, then what it tells here is that for the developers in that company, it does not really change that much. Maybe AI could even substitute programming in the future. But looking at data learning, data models, big data sets, algorithms, if your company needs to enable AI and have big learning models, then you need to hire people like PhD people, like data scientists, very, very specific competences to enable it. And they are really expensive. And they are probably very, very hard to get in the future because everyone wants them. So scarce resources in the future, that will be data scientists. It will be PhD people that know a lot of training, algorithm, learning model, big data. But don't be afraid because Microsoft created it for you. So why are we here today? Because I can show you AI. I don't have any scientists in Projectum. I don't have any PhD people in Projectum. I have Microsoft technology stack. So Microsoft created the Microsoft Power Platform and the Azure technology. And it's there, and you can enable it, and you can enable it in 5 minutes, and you can do it with a low-code developer. So by using Microsoft technology stack, you accelerate your journey so damn fast instead of start learning and building your own learning models and this kind of stuff. So there are low-hanging fruits around how to enable it, and that is simply to look into the Microsoft technology stack. So I don't know if the sound will work, but it is subtitled.
AI, right? It's already there at scale, right? Every news feed, every sort of social media feed, search as we know of it before, right. Chat plus search, they're all on AI. And if anything, they're black boxes. Right. They're more, I describe them as the autopilot era. So in an interesting way, we're moving from the autopilot era of AI to co-pilot era. So if anything, I feel, yes, it's moving fast, but moving fast in the right direction. Moving fast where humans are more in control. More, first of all, humans are in the loop versus being out of the loop. It's a design choice, which at least we have made. So I feel that it's more important for us to capitalize on this technology and its promise of what we're on human agency and economic productivity.
So Satya Nadella says that it's moving fast, but in the right direction. Microsoft made a design principle that humans need to be in control by using AI. So the design principle about what you're going to see today is that I'm going to ask ChatGPT or OpenAI about an advice, and then I can, with my human brain, elaborate on it and do something. It's not going to just run my product portfolio management automatically. So the design principles about Microsoft and AI is that humans are in the loop. They call it the co-pilot. You are co-piloting your company together with AI. And I think that's a really important design principles, because that could put down fears from management team about adopting AI, because human beings are still around and they will still be around. So we're gonna do a live demo now. I'm gonna start by looking into the PPM system. I'm going to put in a strategy as a senior management. And that strategy will to grow the Finnish market by 30% on a new customer base. It will suggest me some stuff. Then I will create some projects to do that strategy. And as a project manager, I will do a project schedule. And I will do some risk management for that project. And afterwards, I'm going to look into my portfolio of entire project portfolio and ask Microsoft Copilot some questions about my product portfolio. So that will be the four enabled AI-enabled user stories that I'm going to do right now. So let's jump into. This is Microsoft Power Platform. I'm logged in as Jacob. Jacob is just an ordinary management dude in this company, and I'm working with my senior management team about strategy. And I'm going to go into my product portfolio management system and look at the strategy area. So what I can do in here is that I can look at strategy. And here I have a list of different strategy. Bear in mind, this is a demo system, so there might be a lot of different examples here. But this is where I can start putting in. So if I want to be the best in class in Denmark, in this company, I can create an objective based on the OKR methodology. And in this case, I'm going to create a new strategy. So I have talked with senior management. We're gonna grow company in Finland. So including spelling like this, save. So this is one of my objectives for my company. I want to grow it. And I could put in a description, grow the Finnish AI market by 30%, focusing on new customer base. That could be one perspective to grow it. And so by saving this and ask generate with AI, what's happening right now is that with use of OpenAI and Microsoft technology, we're going to shoot out this question to OpenAI. OpenAI will elaborate on it. It will come back with some information. And then Projectum, we did some IT magic on top because we want to have the data structured into key results, because key results is the methodology of OKR and the way that that you usually work. So what you see here on my right side now is that it has created actually some ideas and some key results. So to one key result is increased market share in Finland by 30%. I should launch a target marketing campaign in Finland. That's one idea it has to do it. I need to do it in 6 months and 200 hours. So what I could do now is that because human are in control, I could just copy this one and say, I'm going to choose this one, but I'm not going to choose the key result number two. Or I will invent key result number two by myself. I could also just push a button and let it create it automatically in the system. But now I could go down manually and create a new key result. And my new key result, I will paste in the description. And I will just copy paste. And human really like copy paste, right? It's so nice. It's so easy. And this is where I'm in control. I could modify it. So now I've created a new key result. And this new key result, it needs to have some more market share. So what I could do now is that I could say in percentages, I want to measure right now, I have a 0% market share and my target is 30%. That was what ChatGPT suggested. And I'm going to start today and I'm going to end, let's say in a half year as it suggested, and I will save. Now I have objective of grow my company and I'm going to do it by help of increasing market share in Finland. Now, for the sake of the result, right now we have not even started, right? So I'm going to put in the first result, that is today. We are at a zero level. I think we are on track because we're not even started. So this is my first measure of my strategy. If I go up and refresh, I can now see in June, we are 0%. So now we have the strategy in place. We want to grow 30%. We're going to do it by having more market share. But how do we going to do more market share? We're going to create some projects in our company to run this activity of market share. And how do we do that? We're gonna launch this marketing campaign. So I go into my list of initiatives. I'm gonna tell the system, please create me a project. The name of the project should be marketing campaign number one. Jacob should be the project manager. There might be a business sponsor, there might be a status. So I could put in a lot of metadata around. Today, I'm not gonna showcase the PPM system in itself. I'm just gonna show you what's important for AI. So I have a project now. That project is linked to the strategy key result that is linked to the objective of growing. So now I know this marketing campaign gonna, when that is completed, it will then support my strategy. So I could enable strategy and it will automatically find out that it will help increase market share in Finland because the data is just already connected. So as a project manager, I might think, okay, I need to create a project schedule. So I can go to my timeline as a project manager. This is where the project manager will build up the project schedule. In the system, we already have template enabled. So if I was working with a company that are doing clinical trials, pharmaceutical products, then there might be templates in here for project templates that I could use. I could also put on new asphalt pavement on the street if I was in a construction company. So imagine that a project manager could already use predefined templates by your company. But I could also start from AI. So I want to create a marketing plan for selling AI in the Finnish market starting 1st of July with a duration of 3 months. That could be the question that I want to generate a project schedule about because this is a marketing campaign. So what the system does now is, again, it uses OpenAI. It will take about 60 seconds right now. It goes out, ask OpenAI about how does that project schedule look like? It will not bring you a project schedule. If you go to OpenAI now and ChatGPT and ask for a project schedule, it will not show you a Gantt chart. So we did some IT magic on top. So when we received the data for OpenAI, we manipulated the data and we structure that into what a project manager will know as a project schedule. Because there will be a start date, an end date, a duration. There will be a task, there will be stages, there will be phases. So I'm gonna maximize it. And as you see now, it has created a market research. So first start with a market research. I think it's a great idea. Understand the market before you're gonna do something. Identify target audience, analyze competition, then you do a marketing strategy, then you do an implementation. And all in all, it tells you it will start in July and end in September because I told it it should be 3 months. What it also provides me of is this column. This is an AI probability score of how secure are we about the timing. So this task, it has a 5 days and it is 90% sure that it will be 5 days. And you will also see lower scoring like here, monitor and adjust campaign, 50%. It might take 35 days, it might take 1 week or it might take 70 days. So this is where the project manager will have some help from AI to understand the complexity based on OpenAI, but I'm still in control. I'm a project manager and I can start creating Jacob's task and move it around and make dependencies and I can still do whatever I need to do as a project manager. But I started with the help of AI. I could also go down here and say, by the way, add a work package, add some more things. And then I could ask ChatGPT again, please create a sprint of agile methodology based on SAFe, where we're gonna do testing of audience. And then it will come out with a new content that I can put into an existing plan. So this way I can actually open ChatGPT again and work on an existing plan created by ChatGPT. So this is how the project manager go. Now the next thing is that the project manager need to identify some risk and issues to this project. And what we always know is that a project manager will have a risk register. It looks like this. And to create risks, a project manager might start thinking, what is the risk related to this marketing plan? And then I could start creating the risk manually. But I could also add AI generated risk. So I could say, please create 8 risks for marketing plan in the Scandinavian market, or 12 risks or 99 risks. Let's just say 16 instead. Generate. Now, again, with help of OpenAI, ChatGPT, we go out, ask for risk related to the Scandinavian market on a marketing campaign. I will get some answers back. I will also have the information of the impact, and I will have the information of the probability of it, because that's important when I'm doing a risk management. That is to understand and assess the risk. If it's occur, how much impact does it actually give my company or this project? And what is the percentage of probability that this risk will occur? So soon it will populate the risk table. And again, I'm still in control as a project manager, because what I can do is that I can start saying, okay, this risk number 15, I don't care about this risk, so remove it. And then I could add my 10 other risks. And as we are waiting, and bear in mind, it takes like 60 seconds right now to add it. Probably a product manager will use a half day to think of them. So now it actually listed them. If I go down here, you will see cultural differences, brand reputation, competition, pricing strategy, social media and backlash, product quality, and the impact over here. Technology advancement, environmental factors. So now I can actually take some of those and elaborate further on them. I could delete up them, and I can actually use it as an inspirational starting point for my project and risk management. I will save and close my project, because I just created this one marketing project. Now, for the sake of the demo and the transparency for management, I will just create another marketing campaign, because more data is just more nice to look at. So there will be this one. And save. So what I'm going to do now is that I'm going to need more marketing campaigns, right? For this, because I need 30%, and maybe only one marketing campaign will give me 10%. So if I'm gonna, right now I have two projects, a marketing campaign one and a marketing campaign two. If I go to the key result, I could start measuring the value of those marketing campaigns. So if we imagine that right now we are 3 months later, so let's say that we are in just in August. And now we have 10% more customers, and the health needs some attention. We are not there yet. Then I can start look at the progress of my strategy based on those projects and those timing of that project. So if I go right now to a roadmap, I could go to a strategy roadmap. So now I'm senior management. I want to know what's happening in my company. So the first thing I could do is that I could filter my strategy roadmap for the strategy we just created, and we called it Grow Company in Finland. So what we can see here is that I have my strategy Grow Company in Finland. It's a objective for my company, just one of them. Typically companies, they have like 8 or 9 objectives. Grow bottom line, happy employees, happy customer, grow my company, invent new products. To do this, we want to increase market share in Finland by 30%. We created 2 projects. The one project does not have a project schedule, the other one has. So the length of that project that was created by ChatGPT of this 3 months It's now visualized when it has been placed, and I can follow that my key result needs some attentions. And if I'm going to add money to my project, or to my strategy, or hours, or resources, of course, I can now follow in columns what are the cost of my strategy, what is the hours that we spend on it. And this way, by just clicking this link, I will jump directly into that project to understand it further. So I could go to the monthly report, or I could go to a dashboard for this project, and I could start understanding the data. There are 11 tasks in this project created by Chat OpenAI. So this way, management have a transparency of strategy from very top all the way down to practice. And I have used ChatGPT all the way, OpenAI, for creating the strategy, for creating the project schedule, and also for creating the risk register. So the last thing I'm going to showcase, that is the Copilot. So as the CEO of Microsoft was elaborating on, is that how can technology as chat and AI help me? I could use it as reporting. So right now, my portfolio look like this. I have a lot of projects, right? There's a hell lot of projects. Some are red, green, yellow. Some are not started. Some are started. Some have progress. Some have less progress. Some have spent a lot of money. Some has not even started and has no budget allocated. So now I could build Power BI reports and I could make dashboards, right? So I could go to my front page and I could look at our reports. And then I could run Power BI reports. And everyone knows Power BI. So I could create a Power BI report. There are 17 projects with a benefit of this. But then I need to look at the reports. I need to understand it. What if I have a question? What if the CIO calls me on the telephone and asks me a question, Jacob, what is the total benefit of my portfolio or how many projects are red? Then I could actually go in to my project center. And I could launch Power PPM Copilot. So now I have this chat, and this chat has been, and this is a Copilot by Microsoft, by the way. Projectrum did not create this one. We just enabled this technology by Microsoft. We didn't have any scientists. We didn't have any PhD learning people. And I could, if I get the question, what is the return of investment for all projects, right? Have some, then 8.14 is the return of investment. So you could start asking a lot of questions here. This is just example of a question. It could be, what are the number of red KPIs across all projects and what are the average red KPI per project? So there are 9 red KPIs. So basically you could give this chat to senior management and then they could just ask the question directly to the data set of Dataverse with Copilot. So this Copilot is a technology that you will see by Microsoft coming more and more. It will also come in the CRM and in customer service. So if you go and Google and YouTube Copilot right now, you will find use cases by Microsoft where they say, if you are a customer service and the telephone is calling and they're saying you have a customer and the customer is asking of a product specification, then the person at the telephone, they will have Copilot running. And then they will ask Copilot, please give me the product specification for product number 9 for the Finnish market. And then they will give them a link to that document. And then they can share that in the chat with the customer. So the call agent is in between the customer and the data set in the company, put human knowledge in between, but they have Copilot as the help for looking for data. That could be documents, it could be questions like this. So this is Copilot, and you will see it all over the place in Microsoft. You will see it in Word. You will see it in Excel, you will see it in PowerPoint. Copilot will be all around very, very soon. So I think this will conclude my demonstration of those user scenarios. There are probably more user scenarios I could have been looking at from many different angles. So what we're going to do now is that we're going to run into the QA session of this webinar, and we are ready for some questions. As I see it, there are no questions in the question section in the chat. So if there are anyone that want to speak up, yeah, come with the first question.
Yes, I have questions, and if you have any, please put them in the questions section so we can answer them right now. I have a few questions. First of all, thank you for the presentation. It was extremely interesting, and the first thing that came into my mind was that we should take this into use in our company ASAP, and with our steering group, just to get the internal project organized, and to really, it seems amazing. Well, the first question was the kind of technology or the terminology side. So you were talking about OpenAI ChatGPT. Now, as I understand, ChatGPT is the public facing chat product of the company OpenAI. And then the Microsoft technology is based on Azure OpenAI, which shares the name because they invested $10 million to this OpenAI company. And they are using the same language models, but in the Azure OpenAI, they are, the model itself is secured in your Azure environment. So whatever you put in there, it doesn't go into the public internet. So which one are you using?
Yeah, so we're using the OpenAI. So we are on the secure side of everything, right?
Yes.
If you see secure as your tenant. Once, like the question where I ask, grow the Finnish market by AI 30%. This command, when we send it, is also encrypted. So even the sentences that we ship back and forth is encrypted. So it's actually quite secure. And as we know from the Microsoft technology stack, I used to say Microsoft and Google is the best place in the world to hide a dead body. If you go on Google, you should hide it on page 2, because no one goes to page 2 on Google when they do search. They always keep on page 1 and look at the 10 first searches. The same go with Microsoft Azure technology. If you hide a dead body in Microsoft Azure technology, no one will find it because it's so secure. The tenant structure and the data center that Microsoft has, it is probably one of the most secure places in the world to store data. And of course, Microsoft has considered all the security aspect. And I think instead of starting by scratch, instead of taking a developer and start coding something, because everyone can use an OpenAI API and start coding it. Everyone can do that. Just look at the apps. Number of apps that has grown using OpenAI, millions of apps are coming every month. Just now you can chat GPT here and there on your iPhone and whatever, right? Microsoft has at least done it already and have made the connector. There are thousands of connectors that Microsoft has created to external access data that might be for SAP system, that might be for OpenAI. So those connectors, they are well thought. Microsoft has thought about it. So if you should start tomorrow and start in the most secure tech place, I think Microsoft is probably the best place to start.
Very good. So it's a completely different thing to put your company's secret development projects and making the project plan in the ChatGPT. So that's not advisable, because then it will be open and unencrypted in wherever. But then when you're using your tool, you're using the Azure OpenAI, which is a completely secure environment. It doesn't go anywhere, and it's your tenant, and it's everything is thought of, and it's your data, and the answers are only for your eyes and so forth. So yeah, very good.
OpenAI comes with a subscription. This is how they earn their money. And yes, they earn their money by having what they call tokens. So every time you put out a question, you have a token, a connection, and you pay, I think it's $0.02 per token. So just to make that OpenAI into a project context, For $1, I can build 660 product schedule, as I showed you. So just to put into to perspective, you will have a subscription for this OpenAI to use it, but you could build around 650 product schedules for $1. So it's not that expensive.
All right, excellent. Then a few another few questions still. One is, of course, is this what you showed? Is it now available? Is it available for all Power PPM users? Or
what's available is everything that the Copilot. As you saw on my screen with the Copilot, the last chat, then you saw it was in preview in the top. Yeah. That's because Microsoft has not released it yet. So Microsoft, they announced Copilot, I think, 1 month ago, 1.5 month ago. Right now, it's actually only available for US Microsoft customers and tenants in preview. So not even Europe can use it. But we have some good friends in Microsoft, so we managed to get access to development environments with Copilot, and thereby we also have started the development of putting it into PPM context. So we will need to wait Microsoft for Copilot public release. But at that point, we have it ready, because as you saw, we are already doing it now. So we will have it ready when Microsoft. But the other thing, it's ready now. And you can build, now I would say out of the box, you can do what I just showed. But what we experience with customers right now, so if any of you on the call will say, oh, Jacob, that looked nice, but you showed me that about the strategy. Couldn't we change and use AI a little different? So it should propose also some project names. And when it proposes, I will have a button saying create the project. Instead of, I did it manually, right? Copy paste. Then we have the technology and to change the way you want to operate with it, with your business processes. We use Microsoft Power Automate as automation mechanism in background. And it is like a low code. We can like, it will be consultancy and discussion in a workshop. How do you want to have it work? So today I just showed you how it could work. But you don't necessarily need to adopt it this way. You could also say, hey, I want strategy this way, or I want to write a long description of what I want with my company. I press one button and then it creates 10 key objectives and results and 20 projects based on that. And then you look at it and then you say, no, delete it, try again. So it can really be adopted very unique, where Innofactor can go in a workshop and help understanding the customer need and then build the automatic thing. Because that's not where we're going to spend the money. It's within a few hours, you can build a Power Automate, of course, if it's not that advanced, right? So we are talking about days rather than weeks, right? But the technology is there, and if you call me tomorrow, I could deploy it.
Excellent. Maybe one question more. We have 3 minutes left. And by the way, those who need to leave, if you have any questions about it, please contact us. Me or then Jacob in project, and we will come and help you and think with you how you could use these technologies to in your company and to with internal projects, with external projects, with delivery projects, whatever comes into your mind, or if you are unsure how to use AI in general, or are you ready? Is your data ready? Is your security policies ready? Just contact us and we will help you. But one more question that I had is that how do you deal with possible hallucinations with the language model or with OpenAI? Because it's been a little bit, well, there was a case when there was a lawyer who was using ChatGPT in a case, and ChatGPT, it was OpenAI's public version. It made up legal cases, historical legal cases that weren't there. So there is this hallucination issue. So how do you deal with that?
I think that's probably the biggest concern for companies. That is to think about the legal aspects, because the technology is there, but there are no regulation out there. There are no, it's like autonomous cars, right? We had the same discussion like 3 years back. Now you can drive an autonomous driving car, but what if that car drives into another car, right? Who are to be blamed? And the same is around now. We are slowly building up cases in the US with autonomous car. And could you then blame Tesla? Or could you blame the owner of the car? Or could you blame the satellite provider for the GPS loss of signal? The same thing will go with the AI. That is, we need the legal part also following. And that is a management thing in a company to elaborate on if my employees will use AI as a technology.
Right.
How do we then own that problem? Because if you don't make that discussion, you have a problem, because people are already starting going to ChatGPT and put in critical business data in open ChatGPT. So why not take it in on the right side of the wall and manage it, right? Because if you don't do it, using it anyway.
That's the way to go, yes. So the governance and the control and the human aspect needs to be in there. Excellent. Well, our time is up. I could talk to you with this for a very long time, but we will send all the materials to you, to all participants. There are even more slides than Jacob had time to show in this webinar. And just contact us if you have any questions. Thank you very, very much for participating in this webinar, Alna. I'm sure we will see you again. So bye-bye, and thank you, and have a good day.
Hello, thank you for your participation.